हाय फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ संजय एस पाटिल एंड टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग जॉब इवैल्यूएशन एंड मेरिट रेटिंग। नाउ द कंटेंट्स और द एजेंडा ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज डेफिनेशन ऑफ job evaluation, then objectives of job evaluation, then process how job evaluation is carried out, the number of steps that we are going to study, then methods for job evaluation, the various methods which are used to conduct job evaluation, and finally merit rating. Now let's start with job evaluation. Now let's see definition of job evaluation. Job evaluation is a systematic way of determining the value or the worth of job in relation to other jobs in an organization. So in a manufacturing industry, there could be a number of jobs which will be machined. So here we are using or we are determining the value or the worth of the job. Okay, so next is, it tries to make systematic comparison of jobs to assess their relative worth for the purpose of establishing a rational pay structure. Then it does not directly determine the pay levels, but it will establish the basis for an internal ranking of the jobs. And next is most important, evaluation is done by assessing the job pressure. Okay, now the job pressure includes physical strength required to complete the job, then knowledge required to complete the job. So these are the various criteria on which the job is evaluated. Next is, job evaluation is concerned with jobs, not people. That is the most important thing. So we are evaluating the job, we are not evaluating the people for the sake of wage or salary. So we are going to evaluate the worth of the job. And finally, all jobs in an organization will be evaluated using an agreed job evaluation scheme. So for an organization, there would be a common job evaluation scheme, and based on that job evaluation scheme, various jobs would be evaluated. Next, objectives of job evaluation. Now there are various objectives why we have to carry out job evaluation, what is its use, what is its advantages. So first objective is to determine equitable wage differentials between different jobs in the organization. Second, to eliminate wage inequalities. Means, suppose there are two workers and they are working on two different same type of job. Okay. So job evaluation of that both job is same. So that means their wages should be same. So the thing is, by conducting job evaluation, we are going to eliminate the wage differences. Next, to develop a consistent wage policy for an organization. Next, to establish a rational basis for incentive and bonus schemes. Next, to provide a basis for wage negotiation in trade unions. So in a particular year, organization has to negotiate with trade unions for the sake of wage hikes. So for that purpose, for that year, the job evaluation data is very important. Okay, so next is, to minimize wage discrimination on the basis of age, sex, caste and region. region. So we can eliminate all these things by using job evaluation. Next is to establish management to gauge and control the payroll cost. So these are the various objectives of job evaluation. Then next question is how to carry out job evaluation. So there are 6 steps which are used to carry out job evaluation. Now first step is to conduct job analysis. So job analysis means determining detailed facts about the job. So job analysis includes the nature of task performed by the worker, then purpose or objective of the task, then working condition under which the task is carried out, then the responsibility and the skills required to perform the task. So these are the various things that are considered under job analysis. So we have to study all the things to carry out job analysis. Second step is to carry out job description. So now job description means describe the requirements of the job. So here job description in an organization, a job description will be having a sheet, and the sheet will comprise of job title, that is the name of the job, then job code, department, then it will include job summary, then it will include responsible for, then it will include equipment and machine used, then it will also include the working condition and hazards. So for a job description, a sheet will comprise all these things. So for that particular job, we have to fill all the things on the sheet. Next is we have to specify job specification. Next step. So in that step, we have to specify attributes of employee to complete the job satisfactory. So here we have to specify the attributes or the quality of employee which will include the employee's education and knowledge, his experience, then his responsibility for machinery and equipment, then his responsibility for work, then his responsibility for safety of others, then physical efforts required, then mental efforts required. So all these things we have to identify for that particular employee who will be performing the job. Okay, that is the third stage. Next step, that is the fourth step, which include job classification. Okay, so job classification means determining the relative worth of the job. So depending upon the priority of the or the worth of the job, we have to classify the job. Okay, next step is wage determination. So in the previous step we have classified the job. Okay, so in this step we have to compare the job with predetermined job, and we have to determine the wage for that particular job. Okay, and last step is evaluate performance. So based on job description and job specification, we are going to evaluate the performance. So at the end, we will be having the job evaluation for that particular job. So these are the 6 step process which is carried out for job evaluation. Now there are different methods which are used to carry out job evaluation. There are 4 methods. First is ranking method, second is classification method, third is factor comparison method, and fourth is point rating method. Okay, so these are the 4 methods used to carry out job evaluation. Now let's see the ranking method. Okay, So in ranking method, the job is ranked in terms of their importance. Like importance would be in respect of the level of duties and responsibilities, and the job is ranked from lowest to highest. Okay, and it is the most simple method, and it takes less time, or time consumption would be less, and less paperwork is required. So that is the advantage of ranking method. Okay, so next method is classification method. So in classification method, classification system is a process of allocating jobs to grades which are predefined. Okay, so now the grade differences are defined in terms of differences in the level of duties, then responsibilities, and requirement of special skills. So likewise, the job classification system is carried out. Now, advantage of job classification system is it is easily understood by all and easy to use. And another advantage is it is fairly accurate. The only disadvantage of this classification method is it gets complicated as the number of jobs get increases. So as there are more jobs, the system would be more complicated. Now, third method to carry out job evaluation is factor comparison method. So here, five factors are decided, and depending upon that five factors, the job is evaluated. So now the factors are, first factor is mental effort, second is skill requirement to complete the job, third is physical requirement, fourth is responsibility, and fifth is working conditions. So these five factors are considered, and depending upon these five factors are given some points or some weightage, and on that the job is evaluated. Now the advantage of job factor comparison method is it takes into account all the factors that constitute a job. That means it will consider all the things like mental effort, physical effort, skill requirement, physical requirement, working condition that are used to complete a job. And another advantage is this method is also applicable for large organization. Another advantage is directly the money value of the job is obtained. That is the advantage of this method. Disadvantage of this method is it is difficult to explain the rating scale to employee. So for particular employee, it is not possible how the rating is done on these five factors. That is the disadvantage. And another disadvantage is it is time consuming. It takes more time. Okay. So last method is point rating method. So here also number of factors are considered, or it is a stepwise process. So in the first step, we are going to select the various factors. Like factor will include education, experience, initiative, physical effort, mental effort, responsibility for equipment, responsibility for a process, responsibility for work of others, then working conditions, hazard, adaptability, then attitude for learning, initiative. So these are the various factors which we have to define in